Currently, there are more than 500,000 children living at or below the poverty line in New York City. And 43% of those children are single-parent families. Big Brothers Big Sisters of New York City provides over 130 hours of community mentoring, over 5,000 children from these communities, and they also help them to achieve their fullest potential. And joining us now to talk a little bit more is Aaron Frager, who is Director of Recruitment, and Michael Coughlin, who's Chief Program Officer at Big Brothers Big Sisters of New York City. Welcome.
Thanks for having us.
Good to have you. Thank you, Darren.
Good. And so for people who don't know about Big Brothers Big Sisters, first of all, you guys do tremendous and great work. I mean, I'm quite familiar, but for somebody who doesn't know, walk us through a little bit about who they are.
Absolutely. So Big Brothers Big Sisters has been around for more than 100 years. Mm-hmm. And it actually started with a court clerk who saw a lot of kids who were essentially orphans being pushed into the juvenile justice system, arrested, and then being put into jail. And so he did a call to action and said, I need men to step forward and help these boys because there's a different path for them. Mm-hmm. And so today we serve, as you said, more than 5,000 youth. And what we do is we pair young people with adult role models. So 21 or older, and they get a chance to spend 2 times per month with that person over the course of a year, mm-hmm. And essentially bond and help navigate life challenges, help them out long term.
And it's a big difference maker, I mean, in the lives of kids. And it's also a difference maker also for those who actually do the mentorship. And I know that your job is recruiting, right? And so talk to us a little bit more about that and how you're trying to gather more people to come to the table.
So absolutely. So specifically in the Bronx, we have a high need of looking for mentors to recruit to match with youth in the Bronx. Mm-hmm. We have about 60 littles that we have on the waiting list in the Bronx. So that's why, and we found that the matches are more successful if they're paired with mentors that are from the same boroughs and honestly have the similar backgrounds to themselves. Mm-hmm. I myself was a little in the program, so it's kind of fun to bring that whole experience full circle. Mm-hmm. And being a long-term New York City resident my whole life, I understand the impact that you can make as a mentor, and that's what we are asking for. People over the age of 21 to come out and do the same for youth.
So how did the mentorship actually impact you? Because obviously you're sitting here at the table now, right? But it had a profound impact, I take it.
Absolutely. While my 2 years that I was in the program matched with my awesome big, he taught me a lot about doing community service and honestly helped me explore different aspects of leadership and at the time, I was into theater, so he really got me into that and presenting and performing. So he was just a great role model and really helped me push the margin for myself. So that's the same thing that we ask for people who want to be potential mentors.
Right, so the push is out there right now for those to come and be a part, particularly here in our borough of the Bronx, and so we're going to give you that information a little bit later on. But certainly, so talk about, again, it doesn't take a whole lot of time, but there is some time involved.
Correct, yeah. And what we try to pride ourselves on is making sure that this is a volunteer opportunity where you're going to make a huge impact. Mm-hmm. So the time commitment is a little bit. We ask for 2 times per month. It's usually Saturdays and Sundays, mm-hmm. For over the course of the year. But the impact that you can have is profound. So we ask for that year. Most matches actually last for up to 3 years at this point in time. Mm-hmm. The kids who are in our program, 98% of them are graduating from high school, 94% are going on to college, and we actually just launched a new sort of extension to the program because we saw so many kids sort of entering into the college space and want to make sure that our volunteers had that support as well. Mm-hmm. So we now have a college and career success program. So we introduce those same littles to career exploration opportunities. They get college support as they're going through. And of the kids in the Bronx, I think their average GPA right now is about 3.3.
That's great.
And 88% are on track to graduate within 4 years. So we're making huge inroads for those littles. Yeah.
And it does make the difference, right? Because I think that makes the difference, having somebody to be able to relate to and having that opportunity to talk to somebody. What did that mean for you just to have that person is there to be able to be that sounding board, right? And then also at the same time also to be able to get that advice that, you know, to take you there.
Yeah, honestly, just as you said, it's having a person to be that sounding board and also having that person to set the example for yourself. Mm-hmm. As a person of color, it's great to have that role model there to kind of show me what that path could be. And that's something that that a lot of our littles are looking for in themselves, and the families that come seeking the program for their youth are looking for their child.
Sometimes we can get caught up in the type person, right, that you're actually looking for and think, I'm disqualified myself.
Yeah.
But give us who that person is, who you would actually like to see to be that big.
So anyone can be a mentor. There's many different qualities that people can bring to the table. And honestly, it's what we try to meet the youth where they're at. And we explore what their likes are, what your likes are, and that's why we try to make the ideal match for you. Mm-hmm. But there's no disqualifying factors. You just have to be 21 years old,
right.
just about that, and live in the Tri-State area. But other than that, we're looking to make sure that we're meeting the match where they're at, and we can help foster that relationship going forward.
We were talking before the show, like you said, you've been here 14 years, right? And so have you seen the organization evolve over the course of
years? Absolutely. No, I think a lot of the program that we're offering now is sort of providing that roadmap for our mentors to be that change agent for the kids that they're working mm-hmm. with. So every one of the volunteers that we work with has a program manager that's essentially there in their back corner. So they're giving them advice along the way. They're helping them set goals with the student that they're working with. They're giving them training and guidance as they walk through. So we try to make this as easy as possible. So really all you have to do is give us your time mm-hmm. and our magic sauce behind the scenes will sort of make you effective and make you successful.
There it is. So the magic sauce is available. All you have to do is just get connected. And so, Aaron, talk about how they can get connected.
So please visit us at bigsnyc.org or also follow us on all platforms of social media except for Twitter at BBBSNYC.
Yeah, and then you can get connected and find out. Is there a time of year that you find that there's recruitment most, like people kind of like come in? Is it during the holidays? Is it like?
So we are fast approaching that. January is National Mentoring Month, so you'll see a big influx of volunteers, and we'll probably, hopefully, be back.
Definitely be back when we get you back. Yeah, heard that, right, producer? Right.
But yes, National Mentoring Month is coming up in January, and that's where we're going to have our biggest push to recruit mentors across the city.
That's good.
Always a very popular New Year's resolution if you'd like to set one, so
yeah.
To be a mentor for the
yeah.
coming year.
So you got the sell here. You guys are doing great with the sell. So we want people in the Bronx, right? And so give
Absolutely.
Us about the Bronx again and how the Bronx is faring in this whole Big Brothers Big Sisters mentorship.
Sure. So the Bronx represents about 25% of the kids that we work with.
Mm-hmm.
As most of our kids in our program, the kids in the Bronx are excelling.
Mm-hmm.
So 98% of those kids are going on to college, graduating from high school, 94% are going on to college, and now with the college success program, most of them are on track to graduate.
Wow.
So really it is just volunteers stepping forward and being able to change that life.
And you got a waiting list right now, right, for kids to be matched
yes.
up?
So we have about 60 kids that are on the waiting list right now, so that's where we're actively looking for our men and women to step up and become these mentors for them.
All right, so we need about 60. So Aaron, thank you so much. Mike, thank you so much for coming. And hopefully we can get a few more people to get connected.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Darren.
All right, thank you. Now listen, if you want more information on Big Brothers and Big Sisters of NYC, visit their website, bigsnyc.org, or on social media at BBBSNYC. So stay tuned. We got more open. We're coming right back right after this.